this is the last leg of the day. And what came to me, in some of the races, the last leg is the fastest. The last leg, that's when they put the save, the last spurt of energy to go in to get across that line. So are we going for victory?
Yes.
So we're on the last leg, but we're pushing forward. We're going forward. We're moving into what God's got for us. Yeah. Okay. Are we ready to worship?
Yes.
That's, I was going to say that's three people up. I think it's almost as, is that a trick question he's just asked?
Amen.
No, it's not a trick question, but it's an honest one. Are we ready to worship?
Yes.
Yeah. We're not worshipped out.
No.
No. Good. Yeah, because let's face it, we're going to have to learn to do far more than we're doing now, aren't we?
Yeah.
When you think we've got all eternity. How long's that? It's a long time to worship God. But if it's anything like the more we get to know God, the more we love Him, the more we appreciate Him, the more we worship Him. Just think what that's like if we're on a roll. We worship Him more tomorrow than we did today. And the next day we worship Him even more because we love Him more. And then we worship Him the next day, it's even more. Yes. We can't get our minds round that, can we? Well, I can't. Yeah. I should speak for myself, shouldn't I? Yeah. Yeah, but there we go. So we're going into worship and we'll see where we're going.
I had a picture this early this afternoon of a big oak tree and the roots were going deeper and deeper. And I just felt God saying, the deeper we go, the more nourishment we get, the more food we get. So deeper, we're going deeper.
Worthy to be praised.
lift up your name with a sound of singing. We lift up your name in all the earth. We lift up our voice and give you glory. For you are worthy to be praised. For you are worthy to be praised. We lift up your name. The sound of singing, lift up your name in all the earth, lift up our voice and give you glory, for you are worthy to be praised, for you are worthy to be praised. Holy, up our voice and give you glory, for you are worthy to be praised, for you are worthy to be praised, for you are worthy to be praised. Holy, to be praised. Let's do what the song says. Lift up our voice and give him glory.
You're saying he has done, he will do, but he's actually, he is doing great things. And I just felt you needed to declare that. you know, to actually say, when you sing, he is doing great things. And it's, our eyes just need to be opened more to seeing the great things he's doing. So can we just sing that, but he is doing great things, because otherwise you're always waiting for the next, you know, but he's doing it now.
He is doing great things. He is doing great things. He is doing great things. Bless his holy name. He is doing great things. He is doing great things.
Things. Yeah. Are we right to put our God to the test? No, it's no, seriously, we're speaking that out. And Palmer just came to me there, and there's a number who have confided in her that they need prayer for healing. I'm not saying there's a lot of good things, a lot of healing's already taken place. And she said, could we do it afterwards? Well, I know, I think the time's now. We're not going to put it off. We're going to start praying for healing. God is doing. He is in the process of, even now, as we speak. So any sickness that you've got, we're declaring God is ministering. And we're going to pray, you know, come forward for prayer. We're going to do it at the front. Yeah, come on, who's praying? Forward. Yeah. Yeah. Yes.
He will do great things. He is doing great things. Bless his holy name. He is doing great things. He is doing great things. He is doing great things. Bless his holy name. Doing great things. He is doing great things. Bless his holy name. He is doing great things. He is doing great things. He is doing great things. Bless his holy name. Doing great things. He is doing great things. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. And all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. For he is doing great things. He is doing great things. He is doing great things. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy. The Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Lord, O my soul, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his. Sound of heaven touching earth, our Father. All of heaven rolls your name, sing louder. Let this place erupt with praise, can you hear it? The sound of heaven touching earth. The sound of heaven touching earth, our Father. Of heaven rolls your name, sing louder. Let this place erupt with praise, can you hear it? The sound of heaven touching us. The sound of heaven touching us. Spirit break out.
Oh yes.
Oh yes. Break our walls out. Spirit break out, heaven come down. Spirit break out, break our walls down. Spirit break out, heaven come down. You're the name we're lifting high, your glory shaking up the earth and skies, revival. We want to see your kingdom here. We want to see your kingdom here. Spirit break out. Break our walls down. Break out, come on, heaven come down. Spirit break out, break our walls down. Spirit break out, heaven come down. Jesus, you're the name we're lifting high, your glory shaking up the earth and skies. Revival, we're going to see your kingdom here. kingdom here, King of Jesus. You're the name we're lifting high, your glory. Shaking up the earth and skies, revival. We're gonna see your kingdom here. We're gonna see your kingdom here. Spirit, break out. Break our walls down. Spirit, break out. Heaven, come down. Spirit, break out. Break our walls down. Spirit, break out. Spirit, break out. Heaven, come down. And if you just want a fresh touch, why not come forward? Come for a fresh touch. Come for a fresh infilling. If you feel you're thirsty and you're hungry, why not come? Why not come? Our spirits need as much healing as our bodies from time to time. If you need a fresh touch, come. Come and drink. The water is free. Come and drink. Come and drink. Spirit, break out. Break our walls out. Spirit, break out. Heaven, come down. Spirit, break out. Heaven, come down. Spirit, break out. Take our walls out. Break out, heaven. Oh, yes. Heaven, come down. King Jesus, you're the name we're lifting high, your glory. Shaking up the earth and skies, revival. We're gonna see your kingdom here. We're gonna see your kingdom here. Spirit, break out. Break our walls down. Spirit, break out. Heaven, come down. Spirit, break out. Break our walls down. Spirit, break out.
Yes, sir.
Heaven, come down, King Jesus. King Jesus, you're the name we're lifting high, your glory. Shaking up the earth and skies, revival. We're gonna see your kingdom here. We're gonna see your kingdom here. Spirit, break out. Break our walls down. Out. Heaven, come down. Spirit, break out. Break our walls out. Spirit, break out. Oh. Heaven, come down. King Jesus, you're the name we're lifting high, your glory. Shaking up the earth and skies, revival. We're gonna see your kingdom here. We're gonna see your kingdom here, King of Jesus. You're the name we're lifting high, your glory, shaking up the earth and skies, revival. We're gonna see your kingdom here. We're gonna see your kingdom here, King Jesus. You're the name we're lifting high, your glory, shaking up the earth and skies, revival. We're gonna see your kingdom here. We're gonna see your kingdom here, King Jesus. You're the name we're lifting high, your glory, shaking up the earth and skies, revival. We're gonna see your kingdom here. 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 We're gonna see your kingdom here.
Spirit, come down.
Hear it break out. Heaven come down. Spirit break out. Heaven come down. Thank you. just want to praise you. Lift my hands and say, I love you. You are everything to me, and I exalt your holy name on high. I just want to praise you. Lift my hands and say,
respond to you.
Holy Spirit, we worship. Oh, Jesus, we adore. For you are the King of glory. We worship and adore. For you are the Holy One. You are the King of kings. You are a mighty God above all other things. We'll praise you. We'll lift our voice to you. And we'll praise your holy name, King Jesus. We'll worship only you. I love you, Lord, and I lift my voice to worship you. Oh, my soul, rejoice. Take joy, my King, in what you
stood on a mountain. Moses stood on a mountain, waiting for you to pass by. You put your hand over his face. So in your presence, he wouldn't die. And all of Israel sang the glory as it shines down through the air. show me your face. Show me your face, Lord. Show me your face. And lingered up my legs that I might stand in this holy place. Show me. David knew there was something more than the ark of your presence. In a manger, Messiah was born among kings and peasants. And all of Israel saw the glory as it shines down through the age. Now you've called me to boldly seek your face. Show me your face, Lord. Show me. Could just see your face. Moses stood on a mountain, waiting for you to pass by. You put your hand over his face, so in your presence he wouldn't die. And all of Israel saw the glory as it shines down through the age. Now you call power and your it to the end. If I could just see your face, I could make it to the end. If I could just see your face, I could make it to the end. If I could just see your face, oh God. Lord, let your glory on that ancient day, songs of enduring love, and then your glory came. And as a sign to you that we would love the same, you are good. good, and your love endures. You are good, you are good, and your love endures today. You are good, you are good, and your love endures. You are good, you are good, and your love endures. You are good, you are good, and your love endures today. You are good, you are good, and your love endures. You are good, you are good, and your love endures. You are good, you are good, and your love endures today. Oh God, you are good, you are good, you are good, and your love endures. You are good, you are good, and your love endures. You are good, you are good, and your love endures today. You are good, you are good, and your love endures. You are good, you are good, and your love endures. You are good, you are good, and your love endures today. Mention of your name, mention of your name. You're here with the grace of the Savior, with the heart of the Father. You're all we need. Let's go from the top again. You're here. You're with the grace of the Savior, with the heart of the Father, you're all we need. You're here with the hands of the Spirit, you're all we need. At the mention of your name, every chain will break. I know everything will change. Wind and waves at the mention of your name. You're here. You're the provider. You're here. You're the provider. All I've ever needed. You're here. at the mention of your name, every chain will break. I know everything will change. Jesus, at the whisper of your name, the silence will.
Emmanuel, God with us. And that's what we've been hearing and what we've been feeling, what we've been seeing. For those on Zoom, I hope you've enjoyed the music, because you won't have been able to see what's happening here. But there's been a lot of carpet covered, put it that way, and people being touched. It's a little bit after where we said, but never mind. We're going to ask so to come up and minister to us now.
I don't know if I can look at anybody because you get something on.
Wow. Don't you love Holy Spirit? Don't you just love Holy Spirit? Some of you tonight need to have a real dose of Holy Spirit. Because when you've not laughed for a long time, the joy of the Lord just brings healing and wholeness and restoration. And sometimes as Christians, we can be so heavy and so serious. And we just need that touch, don't we, from the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And, you know, people all around us need the Holy Spirit. They need that touch of the Holy Spirit, don't they? And we have the privilege of carrying his presence out wherever we go. I want to start at Romans 8, 19. I can't even look. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Keep coming. Keep coming. There's people over there. You need a dose of Holy Spirit. Home, you need to dose the Holy Spirit. And they're laughing as well. Just receive it right now. It's like Chris Finn. Chris Finn, you need to dose of the Holy Spirit. Receive it right now. Joan. Hi, Joan. Shall we send a dose of Holy Spirit to Birmingham? Are you ready to receive it? Yeah. Yeah, Father, we just thank you for your Holy Spirit that you're moving right across the nation right now. I've got that script, you know, that the God wants to give you immeasurably more. They're catching it in Birmingham. Oh, praise God. People at the back receive Holy Spirit. Oh, thank you, Lord. Lord, we pray, Lord God, that we just receive a dose of the joy of the Lord that just breaks religion off us. Lord God, that just breaks every confinement off us. Lord God, that men's broken hearts, Lord, that heals us, Father. Lord, that we are carriers of joy in a world that's so dismally sad. Lord, let us be vessels of joy. Lord God, we pray in Jesus' name. Here we go. Amen. So what were you blowing it for? What were you releasing?
The breath of God in this place.
The breath of God. Does anyone need the breath of God? Does anyone need healing in your lungs? Seriously, anyone need healing? Just come and we'll pray. She's on the floor. Yeah. Can we just have some people to just come and pray? Just come and pray right now. Maybe you need to blow the shofar over them. Yeah. Yeah, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, we just speak to lungs right now. And Father, we break, Lord God, the effect of asthma, of COVID, Father, of COPD. Father God, we break that off right now. Lung cancer, we break it right now. We command it to be gone in the name of Jesus. Father, we just release healing and wholeness right now in Jesus' name. Just release immeasurably more healing. Lord God, immeasurably more miracles, Father. Lord, immeasurably more, Father, breakthroughs, Father. We release immeasurably more finances, Father. Lord, we release, Lord God, immeasurably more, Lord God, champions of God. Not just people of God, but real champions of God, Father, that are going to pioneer new things in this area, Father. We release, Lord God, immeasurably more, Father, than we can dream or imagine. Lord, we release, Lord God, dreams, Father, fresh dreams, Father, dreams in the day, dreams in the night, Father. Lord God, that you'd stretch our imagination, Father. Lord God, that we have, Lord God, dreams of the impossible, Father, things that we pray, a restoration of dreams, Lord God, that have been put on the shelf, Father, and have been shut down, Father. We just thank you, Father, that you are the dream giver, Father. Lord God, we pray for that everything from heaven, Father, that has got your name on it, as you're here tonight, just really pull it down right now. Just receive it afresh in the name of Jesus. Everything that the locusts have eaten, everything that the enemy has destroyed and robbed, even everything that the church has robbed you of in the past season, Lord, we pray a restoration of it right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray a release again of identities, Father, where people have been robbed of their identity, Lord God, of who they are as your sons and your daughters, Father. We release, Father God, Father, fresh mantles, Father, a breakthrough, Father. Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus, we release a favor, Father. Lord God, where people have had doors shut in their faces before, Father, we pray that favor will begin, Lord God, to open the doors, Father. Lord God, doors of power and doors of authority, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. 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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. 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 Hello. How are we on the screen? Hey. We just send it to you. We send you a release of the Holy Spirit right now. Alma, we just release a blessing upon you, my darling. We just send it to you right now in the name of Jesus. And dear Sandra, we just hope we might see you tomorrow. We just send the love of God to you right now, the blessing of God. To Julie, I don't know whether you're there or not. We just release the blessing of God to you right now. To our wonderful ladies, Chris and Joan from our team, we bless you in the name of Jesus. We just release the fullness of God right now, in Jesus' name. Thank you that you're the same Holy Spirit in Birmingham, Lord God. We just pray a real blessing right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. It's a little bit chaotic here. It's a little bit chaotic, but I'm sure we'll be back with you in a minute. Maybe. Hallelujah. Well, we only got to a little bit of Romans. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do you know what? I love how you have nice little pillows here. It's lovely, isn't it? Lovely pillows, and we'll have to get some pillows. We need some pillows like that for the big push, don't we? Yeah. Some nice blankets. Gorgeous. I just sense the couple here. I just really feel we need to pray for you. Is that okay? Yeah. Yeah. To pray. Father, we just thank you for your Holy Spirit. And again, Father, we just thank you for your precious Son. Lord God, we just pray that you just fill him and fill him and fill him right now. Right now, right now, right now, Lord God. Fill him with hope and joy and peace. Fill him with your fire. Father God, I pray that you just anoint his hands. Anoint his hands, Lord. Thank you for everything you put in his hands, everything you trust him with, Lord God. We just pray healing, healing right now. Lord, we just break disappointment off right now in the name of Jesus. We just say, Lord God, just bring restoration Lord God, of everything that the locusts have eaten, Father, we just pray restoration and healing right now. Lord God, and I just want to pray restoration of finances as well. Father God, that you would just, Father, Lord, even turn minuses to pluses, Lord, where there's anything being robbed from them. Father, we pray right now a restoration. Everything that's been unjust, Father. Lord God, we pray, Lord, a real restoration. In Jesus' name. Yeah. Yeah. Amen. Okay, we're going to go to Romans 8 and start again. Verse 19. For the creation waits in eager expectation for the children of God to be revealed. And, you know, the children of God sometimes have looked quite po-faced. And the children of God have looked quite religious and miserable. And the children of God sometimes look like, you know, the preachers that stand on the corner and condemn everybody. And so it's no wonder that people walk a million miles in a big circle to avoid them. And, you know, God wants to restore the joy of the Lord. He does. We should be the most hopeful people. We should be the most joy-filled people despite what is going on around us, because our hope is in the Lord and not in the world. And I love it. For creation waits in eager expectation for the children of God. You know, Angela, I just want to honour, and I know she hates it, and I know she'll be dead embarrassed, but people like Angela are worth their weight in gold. And we need to be actually honouring the Angelas of this world. We need to be saying, God, how do we release immeasurably more? How do we enable and empower people who are out there where all creation is groaning? How do we empower people who are Jesus' hands and feet out in the marketplace, out in the broken world? You know, Angela was saying how it's breaking her heart, and I can understand. She's dealing with how many suicides a week get threatening?
Within a month, we had eight
people threatening suicide in a month. You know, and this is very deep and very real and very broken. This is all creation groaning. All creation is in eager expectation that the bank managers are not going to meet their needs. They're not. You know, it doesn't matter whether it's Rishi Sunak, whether it's, you know, whoever, say, Keir Starmer. It doesn't matter who is sitting in number 10. You know, they're not going to meet the needs of these people. And everybody is waiting, I really believe, for the sons of God to arise. For the daughters of God to arise, because we're the ones who can release the open heaven. We're the one that can begin to see a transformation of people's lives. We cannot afford to just give people a sticky plaster and send them away. We have got to see the people of God so full of God's power that when we encounter people who are really broken, they encounter the presence of God. And it gives them hope. And it begins to break the demonic hold of poverty that has absolutely strangled the life out of people. People who've got no hope of a house or a job. You know, Angela was telling us how many people, Angela, were coming looking for children's, looking for baby stuff. How many people? 40? The last 3 months has been 40 families who have come with nothing. That's terrible. And it should break our hearts, because it breaks God's heart. And we need to be ringing the bell and blowing the shofar to wake people up. How can we help? What's God's strategy? We can't leave it to a little handful of people doing the best they can. We've got to start crying out to God. We've got to start praying. We've got to start standing in the gap, haven't we, to see how we can help with all of that. Creation waits in eager expectation for the children of God to be revealed. This is God's word. The waiting in eager expectation. Wow. Robert said when we started the meeting yesterday, and I think way back this morning when we started the meeting, are you expectant? And we know what expectation feels like. You know, but the word says, you know, all creation is waiting in eager expectation. I'm sure, you know, in farming country, there is a time when all creation is groaning with expectation, waiting for the farmers to come and harvest. And if you don't do it at the specific time, it's ruined, isn't it? There's an eager expectation that all creation is groaning. And, you know, there's a harvest out there in the spirit realm. And we were saying earlier on, you know, God is not saying it's time to prepare anymore. God's saying, get out and go. And as you go, I'll equip you. As you go, I'll empower you. As you go, I'll resource you. You know, come into agreement over what God's telling you to do and how he's telling you to go and where he's telling you to go. Like Deborah and Barrett, they knew exactly where they needed to go, when they needed to go. They knew the strategy of who had to go with them. And that's how we need to be, isn't it, in this day, that God is looking to deploy his people. He's looking to deploy the 10,000 for the sake of the whole nation. The whole nation was in oppression, and it just was waiting for one man, Barak, to deploy the 10,000 to turn a nation around. Wow. They're pretty good statistics, actually, aren't they? We have less than that number of people in a football stadium. Well, at Liverpool's we do anyway. I don't know what your local team... Who's your local team? Haven't got a clue. So you're not filling the stadium. Who? Hull FC. Yeah. You know, so we have less people, don't we? We have more people in our football stadiums. And it only takes a handful to start turning a nation when we come before the Lord as his children and we begin to cry out. God wants to reveal you. Angela, God wants to reveal you. And it's like, no! We're like, no, God, we really like to stay hidden. And I'm a bit like that. And we're like that. But actually, those days are over. And actually, if we're dead to ourselves, we've just got to do what God tells us. And some people will be in the background, but God is going to be raising up other people who have been hidden in the last season because you've been in the dark place, like was spoken about earlier. Was it today? I can't remember. Sometime recently when God spoke about diamonds. You know, you've been in that hidden dark place and you've been under pressure and God is bringing you to the surface because those diamonds are valuable and they're valuable to God. The creation was subjected to frustration. You know, we felt frustration. Have you felt frustration? Oh my word, I've wanted to shake the church. I've been going into the Anglican Cathedral in Liverpool. Oh my, I was so naughty. The spirit of naughtiness came on me. I had to literally walk with my hands in my pockets to stop myself from ringing the bells. Honestly, I was so frustrated. Because what you're saying is an offence to God. And, you know, they had this installation, an art installation, and people were coming from miles around to see this incredible art installation. And I just felt sick. And everyone's walking around with a silent hush going, isn't it wonderful? And I'm going, it's flipping awful. It's terrible. It's breaking God's heart. This is meant to be a place of worship. And we got in front of the altar and there's this art installation. In front of the altar where it should be worshipful. And I started to sing and my voice has been terrible because I've had this horrible cold. And I started singing, turn your eyes upon Jesus. And there was no sense of God's presence whatsoever in the place. There just wasn't. But the moment I started to sing and lovely Sue Williams was with me, she sings better than me. And we were singing, turn your eyes upon Jesus. And the presence of God just started to fall. And you see, all creation is waiting. And sometimes it means us singing something where everyone's quiet. Sometimes we've got to do something that just begins to open the heaven. To open the heavens that the King of Glory can begin to move. Because he's waiting for you. And he's waiting for me. And you might think, oh, he's not really waiting for me. You know, I'm not real. I'm not a real Christian. You know, Robert's one of the real Christians. He can do it like all the time. I'm just like, we put ourselves down. We absolutely put ourselves down. But God's saying, you are the real deal. He loves you. He's passionate about you. He wants to fill you with his power and his glory and his miracle working power because the world is waiting. All creation is groaning for the manifestation of the sons of God. Creation itself will be liberated from its bondage to decay. Praise God. Praise God. And brought into the freedom and glory of the children of God. You see, how much freedom and glory can we bring if we're not walking in it ourselves? And that's why God's saying, deal with your stuff. You know, deal with it. Just come before God and tell him. Allow him to search your heart. Allow him to just move in you. He can do in an instant, you know, what it would take surgeons hours to do. He's an absolute master surgeon at dealing with hearts, isn't he? And dealing with minds. We know that the whole of creation has been groaning as in the pains of childbirth. Has anyone had pains of childbirth? I'm sure the men have really appreciated that. When you've been with your wives and it's really hurt you when they've been squeezing your hands, I'm sure that's been really difficult for you. But the birth pangs of childbirth, I want to tell you, it's very painful. The whole creation is groaning. You know, when I gave birth to my daughter in particular, I didn't make it into the delivery room in time. And so I hadn't had all the drugs and things that they were supposed to give you. And so I was screaming. I wasn't groaning. I was, in fact, you might have heard me over here, actually. but I was letting rip, you know. And it was like, Mrs. Sinclair, can you please just be quiet? And I'm like, no! you know, because she just came and that was it then. But, you know, if there's a groaning and a crying like that of childbirth, you know, we must be absolutely deaf if we're not hearing it. And we need to be hearing it. Angela's hearing it every day, day after day, after day, after day. And she needs support. And people like Angela who are at the coalface, literally, we need to hold their arms up. We need to be praying for them. You know, we need to be reaching out and saying, what you're doing is not going to fail on our watch. It's not going to, because God hears the cry, he hears the groan. You're here for such a time as this to be the answer. How often has God spoken to us and we've looked at the enormity of the task and chosen to stay where we are? I've done that. It's nice just hiding away. Nice, we've had a lovely team. We love being team. We love doing our stuff together. We love having nice fun in here with the Holy Spirit. It's great. But actually, he's telling us to take him out. He wants to go out. He wants to move in power out there. And when we give him half a chance, he does. He does. He just moves in power, transforms people's lives. It's so awesome. People suffer when we don't obey the Lord. I want to tell you a story around the story of Deborah and Barak. Again, you would be surprised to hear. But the Lord, I was ministering in Uganda, and I was speaking at a church I'd never been to before, and a car came and picked me up. And when I'd woken up that morning, the Lord had said to me, Lapidoth. And I'm like, oh, who is Lapidoth? What is Lapidoth? Where is Lapidoth? What does that mean? You know, didn't know what God was talking about. So this car came. I was taken to Pastor Frank's church, and I'm like, God, you need to tell me a little bit more. I need another clue. And then by that point, I'd found out that Lapidoth was married to Deborah and was mentioned in one verse in the whole of the Bible. And so I'm, okay, God, I've got a clue now. You know, Lapidoth was married to Deborah. So I arrived at the church, and they'd been worshipping for hours, you know, as they do in the African nations. And Pastor Frank said, oh, he said, we're going to do the peace now, you know, and everybody stopped what they were doing and went to do the peace and embrace one another. And this lovely lady came over and she said, oh, hello. She said, my name's Deborah. So I was like, oh, ping, there's another clue. She said, my name's Deborah, I'm Pastor Frank's wife. So I'm like, oh, okay. So when I'd finished speaking and sharing what the Lord had laid on my heart, I said to the Lord, do I pray for everybody now? Because like in Uganda, when you start praying, you know, you can be there for 8 hours, you know, because the whole village comes and then they go to the next village and bring them. And it's like people come from all over the place and you're just there forever. And the Lord said, no, I don't want you to do that. He said, what I want you to do, he said, is just call the leadership team. And so I said, okay. And we'd been in this church and it was really dark. You know, it was the morning, but it was really dark. It was dark spiritually and it was dark physically, overshadowed, you know. It was a really dark place in both respects, really. And the Lord began to speak. And, you know, I said to Frank and to Deborah, you know, I'm really sorry I've never met you before, but this is what I believe the Lord wants to say to you. And I just began to prophesy over that. And I said, you know, Pastor Frank, your wife Deborah is really unhappy. And she is really miserable. And your marriage is really struggling. And I said, but I want to tell you why. The Lord has shown me that she is an evangelist. He's created her to be an anointed evangelist, like the office of an evangelist. And she's doing her best to be a good pastor's wife, when in actual fact, she's an evangelist. And it's killing her because she's trying to be good and do, you know, all that is required of her as a pastor's wife, when actually God really wants her to do what she's created to do. And I said, I really believe that if you will release your wife, you know, so many times a year for a week or 2 weeks just to go on mission and do evangelism and train people up, God will equip her and empower her and resource her. And then the rest of the church leadership, you need to get around them because they're going to have to do church a little bit differently. And I said to Pastor Frank, if you would agree to release Deborah, I really believe God is going to give you a new church. And so off I popped, you know, and then the following year or 2 years later, I went back again And I'm like, Lord, this doesn't look like Frank and Deborah's church where we went last time. And we went down this track and onto this beautiful big field in the middle of the country. It was gorgeous, really light and bright and gorgeous. And I arrived and Pastor Frank came out to greet me. And there was this half-built church, because they build it as they get bricks, don't they, in Uganda. So it was half-built and they were still, you know, raising money for a bit more bricks and stuff. And what God did was, as Pastor Frank released his wife, Deborah, she went off on mission and she began to really operate in the anointing that she carried. And she was leading literally thousands of people to Jesus and raising up leaders, putting them in place, planting churches, raising up evangelists, you know. And in a year, she had just led loads and loads of people to Jesus and planted dozens of churches. And goodness knows what the numbers are now, because it's just going on and on. And she's just, you know, God's really powerfully using care. And Pastor Frank said, you know, from the moment I said yes, that Deborah could go, somebody came to me and said, we want to give you the money to buy this field. And so they bought the land for them. And then other people came and said, we want to buy some bricks. And, you know, God just began to provide for this amazing new church. Pastor Frank now is one of the leading prayer leaders in the whole of Uganda. And he's traveling himself now, you know, leading prayer in an apostolic way all across the nation, big prayer rallies and training people up. And the church is thriving. And, you know, their marriage is really happy. And, you know, it's all about, you know, the Deborahs and the Lapidoths understanding that actually we've got to do things in a different way. And, you know, it was a blessing for me and Ali, because, you know, we've just received prayer and prayer for our husbands, because our husbands could say, no, you're not going to travel. And no, you know, Steve could have said in the year 2000, when God began to call me out, no, you can't do that. I need you to go to work. I need you to be like everybody else's wife that goes and goes to a normal job and earns money. But, you know, he knew that God had set me apart, you know, to serve the Lord. And so he sacrifices by working offshore to enable me to do what I do. And he's a real hero. And people don't see that because they only tend to see him occasionally. But he is my superhero beside Jesus. You know, he is my superhero because he sacrifices to let me do what I am called by God to do. And it's about how in this time, you know, do we begin to release people, not just to be what we expect them to be, but to actually, you know, be released to flow in the anointing and the gifting, whether that's used in the marketplace, whether that's used in the local school, whether that's used, you know, in the NHS or all the different spheres of life that we live in. You know, we're not a successful church when we've got everyone functioning just within the building. You know, and I think it's so important that we understand. And I just want to unpack kind of the lessons that God taught me about Deborah and Frank. And, you know, Deborah was a faithful pastor's wife. She was doing her best. She was doing her best, but it was killing her. And we have people in positions around us, don't we? Even in our workplaces. And actually, the job is killing them because it's not what they're called to do. It's not what they're created to do. It's not what they're anointed to do. And we need to begin to identify, you know, what are people's giftings so that we can really release them to do what they're meant to do. You know, people's marriages are affected. Their family life is affected when they're miserable and they're unhappy because they're not being fulfilled. Number two, Frank had to choose to hear the word and receive it. He could have gone, well, I've never met her before. What right has she got to come and say that about our marriage? But you see, the moment I released the word, Deborah just collapsed in floods of tears because she knew that was the word of the Lord. And Frank knew his marriage was miserable and he had to do something. You know, and for us, we need to be saying, God, how do we release one another so that we're actually really functioning 100% in the anointing and that we're being fulfilled? Again, Deborah had to choose. She had to choose to say, actually, it might be a bit scary going out in Uganda all by myself. It might be scary not going with my husband or, you know, going out. I don't think particularly I would want to go out to different parts of Uganda by myself. When I've gone, I've always taken a team with me. But she began to go out because God had told her, and he raised the resources, he raised teams around her. Goodness knows how many lives have been transformed and are being every day, more and more multiplication as more people are getting saved. Praise God. From one word, Lapidoth, God. The church had to hear and say, actually, we're going to come around this couple and do church a bit differently so we can support them to be all they've been created to be. Number five, God is always faithful. He's always faithful. If he's called you to do something, he will equip you and empower you and enable you to do what he's called you to do. He will give you the anointing that you need. Number six, the provision came to enable Deborah to go where God had told her to go and when God called her to go. You know, some of us get frustrated because God has spoken and we're like, we want to go now. And sometimes God's saying, I've just got to put these things in place for you so that you're ready to go. And some of us have been in a holding place for a long time, you know, and I just really do believe we are now in a season of go, like never before. And people are not so frustrated, are they? You know, it's like the horses, you know, in the Grand National or something like that, and the horses get put in, you know, behind the line, or they get put into the little running blocks, don't they, whatever they're called. And then suddenly the gate opens and they're like this, raring to go. And I think a lot of us have felt a bit like that. We've felt the frustration, haven't we, of knowing, you know, that there's got to be more than this. This must be more than this. You know, that was my cry when I was born again. I was going to an Anglican church and you know, it was all right. You know, every week it was all right. And I thought, if Jesus actually walked into this church, people wouldn't even notice. You know, we'd be up to page 16 on the order of service and nothing would change. And I had a holy frustration inside of me that I didn't know why I had it. Until I cried out to God, where are you, God? You know, sometimes we need to take our holy frustration to God. Where are you? What are you doing? That's how I was born again. I was born again in the middle of the night because I cried out to God, where are you, God? I'm not going to church anymore for a history lesson that's 2,000 years old. I want the real deal. I want to hear you speaking to me. Some of you need to say that to God. You've never heard him speak to you. You need to say, I need to hear you. I need to hear you, God. I need to hear your voice. I need to hear you speak to me. I need you to touch me and show me what to do. Deborah and Frank's marriage was happy. Because they were both happy, because they were doing what God had called them to do. There wasn't this constant friction because they were trying to be something that they weren't meant to be. The Lord, when we're obedient, provides growth, doesn't he? A beautiful piece of land, resources to build a new large church. It's finished now, it looks great. You know, Pastor Frank went from being a little pastor in a really dark place to having a national anointing and a national impact because he was obedient to release Deborah. When God speaks and we do what he tells us to do, we'll see the power of God deployed. And that's one of the words God wants to use today. Are we being deployed? Like Exocet missiles are deployed, aren't they? They're sent out of the casings. And, you know, we need to be sent out. We need to be deployed. We need to see every man and woman deployed to be effective for God. It's not our ability, thank God. It's not our strength, thank God. It's not our resources, thank God for that. As with Lapidoth, Deborah and Barak, and also my dear friends Frank and Deborah, when we are obedient, God can move and will move in power. I've said it all day, and we probably might say it again tomorrow. We need the Lapidoths and the Deborahs released to come alongside the Baraks, that we begin to see this oppression of the enemy pushed back. If God has sold his people into oppression, it's God who will break the power of oppression. When God's people hear the cry and the groan of creation and begin to arise and respond, it releases a flow. Angela was saying, they're giving out the cupboard and the cupboard's never empty. That's the flow of God just beginning to release resources. And they might look like big beans. You know what I mean? They might look like children's nappies, but God wants to begin to release a flow of resources that begins to see all creation, all the broken people that live around here, liberated from oppression. It's a demonic spirit and stronghold that they begin to be liberated so they can begin to arise and have a hopeful future. God wants to restore God-given anointings and giftings that restore people's lives, so that people can live and live life in abundance. That's what the Bible promises us. Not poverty, not brokenness. And it's not about us living in fancy houses or having great cars or wonderful holidays and all that kind of stuff. It's about us being able to resource what God needs to resource. Then everyone thrives. Kingdom of God moves in immeasurably more power all around us. You know, I believe that. We've seen tastes of it, haven't we? We've seen tastes of it, and we want more. The word deploy means we break all limitations, including false and fearful diagnosis. That's something that's really irritated me. It's got me righteously angry this year. You know, when people have been to the doctor over something and they've gone, oh, you probably got cancer. We just need to check that out. Oh, we'll send you for a scan. It's probably cancer. And it's the first thing people are being told. And they're coming back going, it's not cancer at all. But there's a whole demonic agenda for you to be fearful. And, you know, we need to break that. Can we stand? We're just going to make a declaration to finish. We're going to be deployed. Are you ready to be deployed?
Yes.
Are you ready, Joan? Are you ready, Crispin? Yay, cool. Alma, thumbs up. Yeah. Sandra, wonderful. Can see you standing. Can see your hand. Yeah, Father, we're just going to make a declaration. Father, we declare in the name of Jesus that we break all limitations, including false and fearful diagnosis. We ask you to activate and empower us for the miraculous. Okay, can I just say, some of you have got your hands in your pockets, some of you got your hands like this. How are you going to receive the miraculous? Are we going to pull it down? Come on. Let's say it again. We're going to say it again from the start. Father, in the name of Jesus, we break all limitations, including false and fearful diagnosis. We ask you to activate and empower us for the miraculous, for victory, for just not until we get out the door, but forevermore. We deploy people, finances, and we bring them into effective service. For God's kingdom and his glory. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Mwah. Bye.
Okay. That's all right. We're nearly on time. Isn't that good going? Yes. Now then, what you heard there was Sue giving something that I thought once she said that, gosh, that's courageous. To speak to a bloke and tell him his marriage is a mess. One, it's the first time she met the guy, and that's courageous, but she was prepared to speak it out. She was obedient. Now then, I don't know what tomorrow's session's going to bring, but I just feel it's right to say, are we going to listen to Sue as she's obedient tomorrow? And Ali, because I'm going to say it, it might slap you in the face. I don't know what you're bringing, but I'm just going to say, are we prepared to receive and to act on what's being brought?
Yes.
Because if Frank had the courage to do it, we should. And just look at the outcome from there. Well, we've got something already here. We're already in a field. So we can move forward, can't we? And we have some of the prophetic words. We've got to roll out the walls. And that was one of the things I actually tried to get paid a while ago, was a picture where the walls came down and then became where the wall fell down, so the building got bigger. And then the wall fell down, and the new wall was put where the building, where that was. And it was for the ever, it's a play on the tent pegs and strengthen the stakes. But that's what I believe God said to us. We're a church without walls. And we've got to keep moving on that. That's one of the things, actually, that's been forgotten. And we speak that into being again. We are a church without walls. Yeah. We're a beacon church. The light's going higher. The praise is going further as it goes out into the heavenlies. How far does sound travel? I'll need somebody to tell me that because I don't know. But it goes a long way. And that's what's happening. The praise from this place is going out, and it's going to go further and further and further. You know, God said when he actually told me to form the church that we were a resource center for the area. We're not just a little village church. And I got my wrists slapped by saying to someone, we're a small church. It was a case, no, we are a growing church and a resource center. And the prophetic words over this place are going to be fulfilled.
Amen.
Yes. As Mike said on last Sunday, God said it, We believe it. It's done. Right. I just want us to finish. I've asked John to pray, to play it, and for us to sing Army of Love.
So many hearts are hurting, so many people in need, so many lost and lonely. Lord, give us eyes to see. We've got a message of healing for those who give enough. We're taking hope to the hopeless, 'cause we're an army of love. We are a world-changing, difference-making, kingdom-building, soul-shaking people of God. We are a light shining, death-defying, gospel-taking, testifying army of love. We've been given a mission, called to be the light. We're standing up in the darkness and pushing back on the night. We've been given a mission, called to be the light. We're standing up to the darkness and pushing back on the night. We are a world-changing, difference-making, kingdom-building, soul-shaking people of God. We are a light shining, death-defying, gospel-taking, testifying army of love. We are world-changing, difference-making, kingdom-building, soul-shaking people of God. We are a light shining, death-defying, gospel-taking, testifying army of love. Rise up, rise up, everyone go and tell someone. Rise up, rise up, tell them about what love has done. Rise up, rise up, everyone go and tell someone. Rise up, rise up, tell them about what love has done. Yes, rise up, rise up, everyone go and tell someone. Rise up, rise up, tell them about what love has done. Rise up, rise up, everyone go and tell someone. Rise up, rise up, tell them about what love has done. We are a world-changing, difference-making, kingdom-building, soul-shaking people of God. We are a light shining, death-defying, gospel-taking, testifying army of love. We are a world-changing, difference-making, kingdom-building, soul-shaking people of God. We are a light shining, death-defying, gospel-taking, testifying army of love.
Bless you all. Oh, yes.
See you tomorrow for next.
Yeah, safe journey, and see you tomorrow for the next instalment. Bless you all. And bye for everyone on Zoom.